high-value care is a relatively new concept, but I think all health systems in the future will be moving in this direction. The main intent of high-value care is to make sure that when we interface with patients, we do something for them or to something, that we balance four things. And those four things are risk, benefits, costs, and patient preferences. As I talk to physicians about high-value care, the risks and benefits seems to make some sense. It's what we're all trained in medical school to be able to balance. What's relatively novel for physicians is the concept of cost. And in fact, some physicians push back a bit when they think we're cutting corners or somehow sort of denying patients care. But cost really deals more with value, that when we do things for patients, we use resources, laboratory testing, imaging, et cetera, that we get value, meaning that there's a difference in terms of their outcomes, bang for the buck, more or less. So the question is, you know, how does utilization mesh with high-value care? And to some extent, they're one and the same. I think when you talk to physicians about utilization, there again is a little bit of a bristling that it's utilization management. Kind of sounds like you're the blood police or the lab police, or worse yet, you're from an insurance company, right? So utilization management, I think, has a bit of a bad connotation with physicians. What I would say in terms of high-value care, and we emphasize, is the goal here is appropriate utilization, right? So utilization management may be kind of a generic term, but appropriate utilization is our goal. So whether we call it lab stewardship or utilization, lab utilization or high-value care, we're all on the same page. I hope if we say that the goal here is appropriate utilization.